So our scripture today is found in the book of Hebrews, chapter 12, verses 1 through 3. And God's word says, "Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles, and let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us. Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy set before us, who set before him, endured the cross, scorning its shame, sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Consider him who endured such opposition from sinful men, so that you will not grow weary and lose heart." You may have heard this story before, but the 1992 Summer Olympics featured kind of one of those heart-rending moments that has probably been played on YouTube a million times at least. In the 400-meter semifinal, British runner Derek Redmond tore his hamstring muscle and he fell hard on the track. And he struggled to his feet and started to hobble. He was determined he was going to complete that race. His father was beside himself, seeing his son in such pain, that he ran from the stands down to the track to help his son, because his son refused to quit, no matter how much pain he was in. Derek leaned against his father, and the two limped to the finish line together. I mean, just, and you can hear, like, when you watch the videos of this, just the deafening screams of the people in the stadium as these two just limp over the finish line long after that, you know, this race had been completed, because he was gonna finish what he started. I love to hear stories like this about people who were just not gonna give up. Quitters aren't much of an inspiration in anybody's book, right? But people who stay with a commitment, no matter the odds, they kind of get our heart pumping, right? They bring a tear to our eye. They make us want to go and do something, right? You know, I know not everybody knows all of my story. Some of you have come in on different parts of it, so I'll give you the Reader's Digest version. But over the last 18 months, I've lost 120 pounds. About a year ago, I discovered I really like running. I am a really slow runner. People walk faster than I run, and I'm okay with that. It's taken me a long time to be okay with that, but I'm okay with it. And last weekend, I ran my first half marathon and finished my first half marathon. And it's something that I never believed that I would ever do. Because when I was at my heaviest weight, I couldn't walk to the end of the street and back without thinking I was gonna die. So to run 13 miles, my head doesn't connect the fact that my body's able to do that. And even while I was running the race, there was a point when I hit mile 10 and I'm like, there's no way I can run 3 more miles. It's not gonna happen. But I had to figure out there was strength in there, that I knew my body could do it. I just had to get past my head that was telling me I couldn't. God gave me the strength. I don't doubt that for a second. You remember in scripture, the man who came to Jesus and said, "I will follow you wherever you go." And Jesus says to him, "Now, before you make that kind of commitment, you need to realize that foxes have holes and birds have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head." So he's kind of saying here, in other words, you got to realize that if you follow me, realize you're going to have difficulties. There's going to be times you're not going to have anywhere to sleep. You're not going to know where your next meal is coming from. There's going to be times that are difficult and discouraging. But after you realize that, put your hands to the plow and don't look back. Let's go on an adventure together. When people start the Christian life and then they quit because the going gets tough, they can become kind of an object of ridicule because it's almost like they become a source of discouragement to some. That's why today's scripture becomes so important. When we look at the writings of Paul, he uses the Christian life. He compares the Christian life often to athletic events, to endurance events. Listen again as I read today's passage, because it's really important to kind of let this sink in. Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles, and let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us. Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy set out before him endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Consider him who endured such opposition from sinful men, so that you will not grow weary and lose heart. In this passage, Paul is not comparing the Christian life to a wind sprint, but to a marathon. He's looking at it in the long run. See, in a wind sprint, you're running as fast as you can, but for a really short distance. But in a marathon, endurance is critical. And the concern is, over the long run, is that you're not going to grow weary, that you're going to be able to go the distance. The Apostle Paul, we know he was a pretty faithful guy because he endured a lot in his life. We know that. We've looked at Paul a lot in Scripture. In his last letter to Timothy, he wrote, "I have finished the race. I have kept faithful. Now there is in store for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award me on that day. And not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing." And that's in 2 Timothy chapter 4. Finishing the race is critically important to all of us who long to be followers of Christ. And I think we can pull out of today's scripture in Hebrews three things that really help us to faithfully run the race that Christ has put before us. We have to be inspired by those who have gone before us. Otherwise, what's the point? We have to remember that we are surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses. There is a lot of inspiration by those who have gone before us. Notice that chapter 12 starts with the word therefore. And we've talked about this word therefore before. That means we got to start looking at everything that's written before that in Scripture. So let's look at chapter 11 in the book of Hebrews. Captain Bob talked about this a couple months ago. We talked about all these heroes of faith. You know, in verse 7, it talks about Noah. We know patience isn't one of my finer virtues. I've talked about that before. But, you know, it's easy in life to complain about, why is something taking so long? But can't you hear Noah whispering in your ear? When you're saying, why am I waiting so long? He can say things like, well, you know, it took me 100 years to build the ark. Yet I kept on building, and then I waited for the flood. You can keep on waiting too. You know, think about Joseph. It's really easy to be faithful when things are going well and fine in our lives. But when the bottom falls out on our lives, that's when it's hard to be a little faithful. And the list goes on in chapter 11, to all those heroes of the faith and what they did and how God was faithful to them and that they kept going in spite of everything that was thrown on them. We can look at them and hear the whispers. Don't lose heart. Don't give up. So when I get discouraged, I can look at those people in Scripture and find inspiration. But I can look at people around me in this room and in my life that have inspired me by their walk with God and say, I don't have to give up. Something else from today's Scripture that we need to look at. We need to be ready because the struggles, they're gonna come. Nowhere in Scripture does it say, as a Christian, life's gonna be perfect from here on out. We don't get that promise. It would be really nice if we did, but it's not there. Sorry to burst your bubble on that one. The second piece of advice that the writer in Hebrews gives us, he says, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles, and let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us. I think when I kind of think about that, the visual that comes to my mind is the old Tarzan movies. You always see Tarzan with that stinking knife in his mouth. Because inevitably, he's always getting himself wrapped up with that octopus, and it's always one tentacle and then another and another, and he's like, well, how am I going to get out of this situation this time? Oh, magically, the knife appears, and he chops himself free, and ta-da! Life's not that easy sometimes. He can get loose from that. Sin is like those tentacles. We just keep whacking at it. We gotta break free from it. We lay it at the cross every time. We confess it. We change our habits. We move on. When we keep picking it up, when we keep engaging in those habits, those hang-ups, whatever it is that's entangling us, that's what's distancing us from God. Back to running. Marathon runners tell us there's two critical times in the race. The first is the beginning, because when you first start running, you feel really good. And the temptation is to run too fast. And then the second time is when you get past halfway, closer to the end, and you're starting to run out of strength. You kind of hit the wall. And you're not sure if you can get to the end. This is where we have to put our trust in God. This is where that we come back to that verse in Proverbs that's so familiar, Proverbs 3, 5 through 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths. If we trust in God, he's going to be the source that's going to allow us to finish the race. We bring the habits. We bring the sin to the foot of the cross. We leave it there, and we go forward. And then the final thought, we fix our eyes on Jesus. And I think that's the greatest part. Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith. Consider him so that you will not grow weary and lose heart. Jesus was opposed during his life on earth. He was persecuted, yet he stayed the course and paid the price for our sins. And every Christian, they need to hear this, because it's so easy to quit in life. When things get hard, isn't it just easy to pick up and walk away?
Sure.
I don't have to do this anymore. But the author of Hebrews says, fix your eyes on Jesus. Keep going. You know, one day, folks, we're going to stand before the judge of the universe. As guilty as we can be, because you know, it's going to be all laid out there. The evidence is overwhelmingly against us. Satan the accuser is going to be there to accuse us of all the sins we have committed. Our only hope we have is the claim that we have the benefit of the cross. So the writer of Hebrews, fix your eyes upon Jesus, because the only hope we have is our hope in him. Amen?
Amen.
Run the race with patience. Oh, I know patience is hard. Don't lose heart. Don't become discouraged. We have a room here of inspiration, because every one of us has a story. We all have our struggles, but I know every one of you has overcome a struggle through your faith, because I've talked to you. I know many of your different stories. Don't quit. Keep going. Keep running the race that has been set before you. There's a song I want to play this morning before we pray, to just kind of think about the scripture this morning. And it's a Disney song. I'm sorry. I would never normally play a Disney song in church. But it relates to our scripture in how we truly need to keep moving forward. Because when we go the distance, when we move forward, we're moving forward closer to Christ. So let's just take a moment and listen to this song.
Will cheer when they see my face. And the voice keeps saying, this is where I'm meant to be. I will find my way. I can go the distance. I'll be there someday. If I can be strong, I know every mile will be worth my while. I would go most anywhere to feel like I belong.
Hercules, there's something your mother and I have been meaning to tell you.
That hero's welcome is right in the arms of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Let's pray. Lord, I thank you for every person here today. Because, Lord, we all have a story to tell. We all have gone the distance at some point in our lives. And I just ask today, Lord, that whatever struggle it is that we face, that you would continue to spur us on in our faith and to seek out that inspiration that we need, to lean more on you, Lord, to seek out that infilling of the Holy Spirit when we need it the most, to find the other people that can speak the words of encouragement into our lives, to find the words in Scripture that spur us on in the dark moments, Lord, to find the comfort and the quiet seeking you, whatever it is, Lord, that you would just bring those moments, those God moments to us. Continue to be with us, Lord, as we go from this place today. Guide, guard, and strengthen us in our walk as we seek you more and more each and every day. And we pray this today in the holy name of Jesus Christ. Amen. And our closing song is number 690 in the songbook.